हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन प्रीवियस टू सेशंस वी हैव स्टडीड द कैरेक्टराइजेशन ऑफ कंटिन्यूअस फंक्शंस लाइक फंडामेंटल थ्योरम ऑफ कंटिन्यूटी। अ फंक्शन एफ फ्रॉम एक्स डी टू वाई रो इज कंटिन्यूअस इफ एंड ओनली इफ इनवर्स इमेज ऑफ ओपन सेट इज ओपन, इनवर्स इमेज ऑफ क्लोज सेट इज क्लोज्ड, और एफ इज कंटिन्यूअस इफ एंड ओनली इफ एफ ऑफ ए क्लोजर इज कंटेन्ड इन एफ ऑफ ए इट्स क्लोजर, और एफ इनवर्स ऑफ बी ब्रैकेट क्लोजर इज सबसेट ऑफ एफ इनवर्स बी क्लोजर फॉर एनी बी सबसेट ऑफ वाई। सो डिपेंडिंग ऑन दैट विल टेक टूडे सेशन फॉर एग्जाम्पल्स। सो दिस इज आवर फिफ्थ लेक्चर एंड विच इज ड्यूटेड फॉर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑन कंटिन्यूस फंक्शंस। So take first example. Let f from Ru to Ru be continuous function such that be continuous function such that fx is equal to say 6 for any irrational x. Any irrational x, so that fx is equal to 6 for every x belongs to Ru. So Ru is the usual matrix space. So solution, since f from Ru to Ru is continuous function, therefore f of a closure is contained in f of a full closure for any a subset of Ru, and therefore f of q complement closure is contained in f of q complement is closure, where q complement is set of irrationals. Set of irrationals, all irrationals in R. But we know that in Ru, Q complement closure is R, and F of Q complement is singleton 6 is closure. Since in Ru, Q complement closure is R, and F of X is equal to 6 for every x belongs to Q complement. This is given. But we know that singleton set is closed. So this is nothing but f of R is contained in singleton 6. Since singleton 6 is closed, implies singleton 6 closure is equal to just singleton 6. Now f of q complement, this is 1, is equal to 6 is contained in f of r, since q complement is subset of r, right? So from 1 and 2, what will get? F of R is equal to 6. And therefore, fx is equal to 6 for every x belongs to R. We also know that set of rationals is also dense in R. Set of rationals is dense in R, and therefore if I replace this irrationals by rational number or this 6 by any constant k, then in that case we will get the same result. Next example. So let XD be metric space and f from x2 are its continuous functions such that from x2 are its continuous functions. So that set of A is such that A is equal to x belongs to x, such that fx is equal to 0 is closed in x. So solution f from x to ru is continuous function. Ru is continuous function. Therefore, f inverse f is closed in x for any closed set f, closed set f in Ru. Here, singleton zero is closed in Ru. And therefore, F inverse singleton 0 is equal to set of x belongs to x such that Fx is equal to 0. Which is A is closed in X. It's closed in X. Okay. So this is by sufficient condition. This is by sufficient condition. Okay. If I take next example, say let XD be discrete metric space. Discrete metric space. Then show that any function f from xd to y rho and y rho is metric space, whatever metric space may be, is continuous. So let G be open subset of Y, open set in Y. Then F inverse G is subset of XD. Now since any subset of discrete metric space is open. What this implies is, therefore, F inverse G is open in XD for any open set G in Y rho. And therefore, by sufficient condition for continuous function, F from XD to Y rho is continuous function. Y rho is continuous. Right? So simple example. But converse is not true. Okay. A function from arbitrary metric space to discrete metric space may not be continuous. Okay. So that next example, let XD be metric space and k greater than 0. Dk is a metric for x defined as dk of xy is equal to k times d of xy for any xy belongs to x. Let I from xd to xdk be identity function. That is, Ix is equal to x for every x belongs to x. So that I is continuous function. So here for x a belongs to xd, d of dk of ix ia is equal to dk of xa, which is equal to k dxa is less than epsilon if and only if d of xa is less than epsilon by k. So from this, for given epsilon greater than 0, there exists delta is equal to epsilon by k greater than 0 such that dk of xa less than epsilon by k implies d of ix ia less than epsilon, and therefore I is continuous at a belongs to x, where a is arbitrary, and therefore I is continuous function. On same line, if I take identity function from xdk, to xd, it is also continuous. Here, I from xdk to xd is also continuous. Here I is again continuous function. So for this, again d of xa, d of ix ia is equal to d of xa, and from this d of xy is equal to 1 upon k dk xy is equal to 1 upon k डीके एक्स ए इफ आई टेक दिस एज स्टार बाय स्टार एंड दिस इज लेस देन एप्सिलॉन, दिस इज लेस देन एप्सिलॉन इफ एंड ओनली डीके ऑफ एक्स ए इज लेस देन एप्सिलॉन के इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा. So from this, for given epsilon greater than 0, for given epsilon greater than 0, there exists delta is equal to epsilon k greater than 0 such that dq of xa less than delta implies d of ix ia is less than epsilon. Implies is I is continuous at A belongs to X where A is arbitrary. Okay, and therefore I is continuous. I from X dk to X d is continuous function. Now, take next example. Give an example of continuous function f from xd to y row. Such that f of a closure is proper subset of f of a closure for some subset a of x. So let f from Let XD be discrete metric space. Discrete metric space and RUB usual metric space. Then identity function. I from xd to rd, here we'll take rd, be discrete matrix, rd to ru as ix is equal to x is continuous function, since I infers G is opening RD for any open subset G of RU. For any open subset, this is your G. Any open set G in RU. Is it clear? We know that. Well, take identity function एक्स बिलोंग्स टू आर, नाउ एनी ओपन सबसेट ऑफ एनी सबसेट ऑफ आर डी डिस्क्रीट मैट्रिक्स स्पेस, सबसेट ऑफ डिस्क्रीट मैट्रिक्स स्पेस इज ओपन इम्प्लाइज फॉर एनी ओपन सबसेट, फॉर एनी ओपन सेट जी इन आर यू आई इन्फर्स जी इज इक्वल टू जी इज ओपन इन आर डी एंड देयरफॉर बाय सफिशियंट कंडीशन, सफिशियंट कंडीशन आई इज कंटिन्यूअस फंक्शन, आई इज कंटिन्यूअस फंक्शन. नाउ क्यू इज ओपन, क्यू इज ओपन क्लोज्ड इन आर डी एंड देयरफॉर आई क्यू क्लोजर इज इक्वल टू क्यू क्लोजर, दिस इज प्रॉपर क्यू क्लोजर इज इक्वल टू आई क्यू एंड इज इक्वल टू क्यू एंड आई ऑफ क्यू इट्स क्लोजर इज इक्वल टू क्यू क्लोजर इज इक्वल टू आर यू. This implies IQ closure is proper subset of IQ. Proper subset of IQ. Is it clear? So discrete matrix space plays very very important role to construct the counter examples. To construct the counter examples. Next example. Give an example of continuous function f from x to y row such that f inverse of b closure, f inverse of b closure is proper subset of f inverse b closure. F inverse b closure. Okay. For subset B of Y, for some subset B of Y. Again, we'll take the same example. Same example. Okay. Let RD be discrete matrix space and RU be usual matrix. Then this function is continuous. Okay. So for this is continuous. Okay. Now, I have to take B to be subset of Y. B to be subset of Y. Okay. So, if I take here B closure. Okay. So, Q is open. Q take Q to be subset of let Q be subset of RU, then Q closure is equal to R in RU implies F inverse of Q closure, I inverse of Q closure is equal to I inverse of R, this is nothing but R, and I inverse Q its closure is equal to Q closure is equal to Q in RD. As Q is closed in discrete matrix space, closed in discrete matrix space RD. ओके, सो फ्रॉम दिस आई इन्फर्स क्यू क्लोजर इज प्रॉपर सबसेट ऑफ आई इन्फर्स ऑफ क्यू क्लोजर. ओके, सो विद दिस डिस्कशन टूडे विल स्टॉप आवर सेशन हियर. लर्न ईच एग्जाम्पल थरोली, डू द प्रैक्टिस, राइट सोल्यूशन अगेन एंड अगेन, बिकॉज इन मेट्रिक स्पेस इवन द सोल्यूशंस लुक्स टू बी टू सिंपल, बट वाई राइटिंग सोल्यूशंस इन पेपर आफ्टर गैप इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू रिकॉल द स्टेप्स. सो राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन थेरेटिकल कोर्सेस लाइक मेट्रिक स्पेसेस, रियल एनालिसिस, ग्रुप थेरी, एक्सेट्रा. सो थैंक्स फॉर लिसनिंग लेक्चर केयरफुली. बाय बाय.